which represents the unavailability of system convergence mechanical word.
Okay, that is also right. Good. So generally, Shruti has given the answer, disorderness, randomness. Generally, we know that entropy means disorderness, randomness. Every system has tendency to get the maximum entropy. That is the characteristic of a system. Disorderness, randomness. Disorderness, randomness means, so just I am giving one real example. Suppose during the physical classes, all of you are in our classroom. Teacher is there, suppose 88 or 89 students are there. If that is you have after half an hour, so the suppose the teacher will allow you to go to the playground. So in that case, if you measure the entropy, if you say the, about the entropy, obviously the entropy when you are present at the playground, that is greater than the entropy when you are present in the classroom. Because when you are present in the classroom, so by default, with pressure, without pressure, your concentration is there towards the teacher. Teacher is discussing something, so your focus, so your concentration towards the blackboard, towards the teachers also. So all the students, 90 students present in a classroom, so they are engaging for a particular discussion also. Am I right? But when you are the playground, there is no particular assignment. You can move here and there also. There is no boundary. There is no particular assignment. So you can go anywhere. You can talk any topic with your friends also. There is no restriction. So that is the maximum randomness. That is the greater randomness, disorderness. Suppose a gas molecule, same gas molecule, one mole, suppose gas molecule, present in 1 liter container, the same gas molecule, same amount of gas molecule, present in 10 liter container. So randomness will be increased. So entropy will be, that is simple physical explanation about the entropy. Randomness or disorderness will be increased. Right. Next, Amit has given another explanation about the entropy. We'll discuss later also. So, when a system is receiving some amount of energy, so a randomness or disorderness will be increased. How it will be increased? Some amount of energy also required. So, total amount of energy not converted into the work done. Some amount of energy also required to increase the entropy or for the randomness or disorderness. These are the physical significance, these are the physical explanation about the entropy. So we can calculate the entropy, the mathematical form of the entropy. Already you know, I will not discuss the details. So already we have given the answer. So dq by dt from the Carnot cycle. From the Carnot cycle, suppose that is one simple reversible heat engine. So same efficiency is equal to heat converted to the work, just we have discussed, and heat drawn from the source. So W net by Q2, already we have discussed W net is equal to Q, because first stage, second, already we know that temperature constant means there is no change of internal energy. In this way, we can write Q2 minus Q1 by Q2. So eta is equal to 1 minus Q1 by Q2. So step by step, if we do it, so we'll see that for the reversible process, again, the efficiency was 1 minus T1 by T2. And from the heat energy concept, we have got 1 minus Q1 by T2. So ultimately, we can write Q2 by Q1 is equal to Q1 by T1. So in the Carnot cycle, summation of these Q2 by T2, Q1 by T1, so ultimately, it will be 0 for the cyclic process. For the cyclic process, so summation of this, so it will be 0, so we can say that. And this dq by t, for the reversible process, this dq by t, this is assigned as the entropy, mathematical form of the entropy. And for the cyclic process, the total changes of entropy, that will be 0, because for all the step function parameter when it is comparing to the original point. So obviously there is no change of value. So that for cyclic process the changes value will be zero. Like the that is applicable for the entropy also. So for the cyclic process summation of dq by t that will be zero. That is the explanation of entropy. Okay. So for the irreversible engine, so for reversible engine and irreversible engine, and we know that already we have discussed for irreversible process, the work done is less than the reversible process. Always the work done through the reversible process is higher than the irreversible process. We know it. The work done for the reversible process is higher than the irreversible process. So that is applicable for the reversible and irreversible, 1 minus Q1 by Q2. That is for the heat engine. So for the irreversible process, we can write again 1 minus Q1 by Q2. And but we know that efficiency for reversible engine greater than the efficiency of irreversible engine. So 1 minus Q1 by T2 greater than 1 minus Q1 by Q2. So ultimately, we have got another relationship. So Q2 minus T2 minus Q1 by T1 less than 0. Q2 by T2 minus Q1 by T1 less than 0. For the reversible process, it was E equal to 0. For the reversible process, it was E equal sign. So for the reversible process, Q2 by T2 minus Q1 by T1 is equal to 0. But for the irreversible process, that is less than 0. Okay, so for the reversible process, ultimately, for the reversible process, we can say that for the irreversible process, cyclic process, so dq by t less than 0. It was 0 for the reversible process, but for the irreversible process, it is less than 0. Both are very, very important. I am telling again. For reversible process, the mathematical expression summation of dq by t for cyclic process is equal to 0, but for irreversible process, summation of dq by t for cyclic process, it is less than 0. Clear? Both are important for your MCQ also. So that is also this. So if you write combinedly for the reversible and irreversible, we can write in this way also. Dq by t less than is equal to 0. Is equal to 0 for reversible process, less than 0 for irreversible process. This is known as the Clausius inequality. This is known as the Clausius inequality. dq by t summation of or for cyclic process dq by t less than is equal to 0. Okay. So definition of entropy I will not discuss again. So already we have discussed definition, and that is the term the entropy also as shown as the S. But you know that we are unable to measure only S, only H, only U. We can measure only the changes of these parameters. So always we will indicate DS, changes of entropy, changes of internal energy, changes of enthalpy. So DS, that is dq reversible by T, and summation for cyclic process DS is equal to 0. Okay, physical significance already we have discussed. Physical significance already we have discussed. So if we know the physical significance of entropy, see the last line, entropy of vapor, much more greater than the entropy of liquid, much more greater than the entropy of solid. Why? Why entropy of solid? In the solid substance, we know that the intermolecular, interatomic attraction force is maximum. Interatomic intermolecular attraction force is maximum, so it has particular shape size for the solid substance. So closely situated in the solid substance, the molecules are closely situated, so that is the solid. So we can say that it has the minimum randomness. So just I have given the one example also when you are present in the classroom. Similarly, in the solid molecule, all the molecules are tightly attracted by other molecules also. So in that case, the randomness or disorderness will be minimum. So, but some higher for the liquid also, obviously the intermolecular attraction force will be the greater than, sorry, less than the solid substance, and for the vapor it has the maximum. It has the maximum, so we can ignore the intermolecular attraction force in the gaseous molecules also. In a closed container, you can keep some gas molecules also, but if you open the lid of the container, cover of the container, so easily it can mix with the atmosphere also, because it has no approximately no intermolecular attraction force. So entropy will be maximum for the vapor substance. Entropy will be maximum for the vapor substance also. And next we'll calculate also for the reversible process, for the irreversible process, what will be the changes of entropy for universe. For universe means, so first we'll calculate the entropy changes for the system. Next we'll calculate the entropy changes of surrounding. So surrounding plus system, that will be entropy changes of universe also. Okay. So next day we'll complete the entropy. Entropy mainly in your syllabus, that is mainly important for your syllabus also. Next day we'll complete the entropy, and after that we'll start the another thermodynamical parameters also. Okay. Or IT, okay. IT. Rule number 1, 2. Rule number 2.
Present, sir.
3, 4.
Present, sir.